can move with how we need to read the data. I tell you what is the difference between reading the data and doing the plots and just learning the plots. When we read the data and start doing our visual plot, the need and circumstances we will understand and we will do. Whereas while learning plot, we will be generating most of the time random number function. We'll be artificially generating the numbers. What number it would generate also we may not able to understand. Upon that number only we can do the plots. So however, let me start with number generation artificially, then we using that set of generator number, let us discuss the plots. Now matplotlib is a package. Just today only I'm introducing package. In the previous session, never we have introduced the package. However, introduced the keyword import. Today, matplotlib is the package we are going to discuss. This package we need to bring to the notebook. Only then it will work. This matplotlib will be available on your secondary memory after the installation. That means your hard disk. Then that matplotlib need to be brought to the Jupyter notebook, or what is the meaning is RAM memory. Only then it is possible to plot. This is the plotting library. There is one more library available, Seaborn Advance, Bit Advance. How these libraries are built is, if you look at, library is built on NumPy arrays. NumPy package is the base package for the matplotlib. Upon matplotlib, Seaborn is built. It is like a layer, like a sandwich, one above the one. NumPy array would be the first layer. Matplotlib is a second layer. Seaborn is a third layer. I'm not going to touch upon Seaborn today. Let us walk through thoroughly this matplotlib. Then slowly we move to the data point. How the data need to understand, I will walk through with the sample data set. Then how to read the data set, if time permits, we will go one by one. Now, import is the keyword we need to use in order to bring the required package name into our computation. So the required package name right now, imagine we would like to use matplotlib. When we bring matplotlib, it is a huge amount of information or reservoir of information is kept it in matplotlib. In order to bring that entire package, our memory need to support. Our speed need to be retained well means we need to bring the exactly sub package also. The sub package which we require within the matplotlib is pyplot. Pyplot is a package I'm interested right now, so that I am mentioning with the dot operator the sub package name. This is the essence we may need to understand. The complete umbrella system, it's a apex name. Matplotlib is apex name within which we are going to bring the sub package pyplot. Next, this is the component optional. If you wish, you can use, otherwise choice is yours. As is the keyword, like import, as is the keyword, PLT is alias name. That what is the meaning of alias name? Instead of this much bigger name, we are making it to be shortened one. So whenever we mean to refer this package for our utilization purpose, we can use this three letter word instead of this much bigger name. That is a concept called alias name. So this is choice is yours. Whether if you are interested, you can use this combination. Otherwise, you can skip also. But whenever you mean to say you are working with matplotlib, every time you need to use this name mention, then typographical error you may commit. You may feel strainful to type this much bigger word. That is a core purpose of going for alias name. Then this alias name, not necessarily to keep only PLT. Choice is your, if you wish, you can keep A also, P also, your name also. But across the globe, although it is given the freedom to user, everyone is tend to use PLT. That part I don't know. Python is giving freedom to use instead of PLT, anything, your name. It is a kind of global common conventional representation, I guess. Although it permits to create alias name, they are keeping PLT. Please remember. Next, import is one more package, NumPy. NumPy is the package, basic package for so NumPy is ASNP. NP is alias name, a shorter notation we are using to represent NumPy. This is the package importing strategies or inclusion of package into our notebook. There are plenty of packages. We must know which package is required for which kind of jobs and responsibilities, then we need to bring it. Some more we need to understand which are all the packages required for our project or our execution, then we need to use this function import. Importing the package, there is one more method is also available, that is using from something like that. I will walk through that kind of importing packages with the other notebook. Right now, understand this is the way to import the package into our notebook or working space. Next, now we are moving to plotting. Simple plot, a line plot, collection of points we want to plot, that's all. Not a straight line, collection of points one after another. What we are trying to do is, look at this, x is the variable or array, NumPy array. We are going to create array of points. The moment we say NumPy, it works on only array. We no need to create array explicitly. The whenever we are tend to use NP, whenever we are trying to use this kind of operations, automatically x becomes array. NP dot linspace. Linspace is the function useful for generating array of points. What is the meaning? Yesterday in the for loop I was demonstrating. This is the initial value, this is the final value, this is the incremental value that we were discussing, you know. Similarly, here we are mentioning initial value, incremental value, that incremental value and the final value, limit value. So within this space, within this given number, it will start generating linspace. 0, 10. Then it will try to generate 20 points. Because if you don't mention, it will take 1 point increment. 1 point increment. Then y is equal to whatever the number is generated by the linspace function, which are all available in x. That x we are going to do square of x. Every number we are going to take square. That we are treating it as y. Then we are trying to use plot function. This is the function we are using, but this function where it is available, linspace is available with the package np, plot is available with the package plt. What is np? Alias name of NumPy, np. What is plt? Alias name of this entire construct or entire package. Plt is the alias name of matplotlib.pyplot. So we want to plot between x comma y. Whatever the x comma y value available in this generation, those all information is taken into consideration and it starts plotting. Suppose if you are so curious about what is available in x, you can print x, just use x and it gives you the information available in x. So these are all the value generated in x, array x. This much information available with the array x. This is the array generated. Whatever the value it generates, see, it starts from 0, ends with some 999, some exponential value. So it starts generating this array of numbers. For every number, for the y we are trying to take square. Simple, between two information, for example, your age and weight, your weight and height, BMS, body mass index, I want to do, I need to have two array of information. There are around 37 participants right now available in this workshop. If I come to know 37 participants weight and height, then two array of information I'm having. I want to plot. What is, why we want to see the plot? What is the way people are related? How it is fitting in that line, how it fits zigzag. That means what? If everyone is of slightly change in weight and height, then it would be easier. Lot of deviation there means line will not come like this. Smooth line we will not get. We will get different kind of graphs. The zigzag line plot we will be getting. So whenever we want to do a plot on comparing two different information, right now we are using linear function. Similarly, we can do cubic function, exponential function. We can draw for the same. Between two information, whenever we want to generate, we need to have two array value. That two array values we can generate. Now, if I have two array values, what is the meaning? I don't recover this. Instead, X is the array of information, or from the Excel sheet, I can import, I can load all of your weight. In the Y column or Y variable, I can load all of your height. That's all. X is holding your weight, Y is holding your height. Versus weight versus height, I can plot it using this function. When the linspace is required, we don't have data, we want to generate, we want to see how it works. Suppose if I am trying to change it into 15, let us see, look it into the diagram. If I am changing it into 15, then the range of information would be up to 15. Then it generates this. Line is changed a bit different. Now what I am going to do, instead of x to the power of 2, I am going to use cubic function. Look at how the cubic function is going to display the, see, cubic. The moment we say cubic, it will become parabola-like structure. So now it is becoming parabola. If I try to take square root, then it would be different. So relation between x and y is represented in this graph. Choice is yours. When linspace is used is, whenever you don't have number, just you want to simulate with number, play around with number, you want to generate the number, then linspace would become useful. Otherwise, it is not required. So with this is the introduction I wanted to start with for the plot. Basic, it is required, matplotlib, numpy. That's it. Then whenever you want to plot, it is two-dimensional plot. 3D plots also available. Python supports 3D plots also. Then we need to have all the time two axes. That two axes only we can plot. So in order to plot what is available, the relativity between X and Y. For example, your weight and marks. Is there, I want to find out relationship between your body weight and mark, which you score in your semester examination. Yes, or why not? So X can be your mark, Y can be your body weight. Anything, two different data point or two different features I want to look at, I can do. Age versus earning. What is your age? What is your salary? 37 members, if I know your age and your salary, I can plot. I can see, look at the relationship. Is age is influential with respect to package? I can find out. Nowadays, IT guys are earning more. Even one of my cousin, she is appointed with Qualcomm with 1,65,000. That offer letter during the beginning of fourth year itself, she got it. But I am not even reached that salary after 20 years of teaching experience. So that analysis we can do. So if it is mixed ground, is there any age influential with package? We can try it out. So this is the purpose of this plot function. If you want to plot just the relativity between two variable, these two variables we want to relate and see what is the kind of relationship it takes, what is the kind of interpretation it is having. If I do fourth quadratic, then see, it is becoming, the curve becoming too deeper. So it represents the relationship between the number generated by linspace and square of that, cube of that, to the power of 4. This is what we are trying to do, nothing more. That's it. Now we move to little bit better way of doing things we are trying to do. We all this requirement assumed that up to this line, up to the first 4 lines, it is continued. I am altering with only the plot function. Plot function is same, but how I am expecting my plot? If you look at this plot, no information is provided. It's a very plain plot. If anyone looks at, they can't even understand what is x-axis, what is y-axis, why I drawn this diagram. This is the kind of annotation. We are trying to do annotation. We are trying to give title. Our first plot, see, I want to change it into capital O, capital F. Now you see the changes will be reflected, capital P. some title we want to give. Similarly, X label, if it is age versus package, then I can give. It is a random number. There is no meaning for that. So that I am just giving X label, Y label. If I have original data, your age and your salary, if I have, then I can understand, is there any relationship between your salary and age, or there is no relationship. That analysis I can do. Now, right now, I am not having the real-time data. I am doing simulation. This is the plot. Look at this. Our first plot, X label, whatever you give, you can give apple, banana, anything you can give, whatever you give, that will display. You are decorating the figure or the display. You are annotating the graph. That is what I can say. These three functions I'm introducing in addition. I would have kept it there itself. Then it will look very larger. You may be frightened. So piece by piece, I want to move. That's all. First, we started with record package inclusion. Then we generated. We don't have real-time data. So I am simulating two different set of data. One is X, one is Y. I'm giving relationship between these two, common relationship. That is why no distortion, a smooth line display is happening, because I'm giving the relationship square, cube, and to the power 4, some kind of relationship only. I started giving one after another. That relationship is plotted here. Now, in the second stage, I'm explaining you how we can decorate the graph. So giving one title for the nice title for the graph, annotation for the x-axis, annotation for the y-axis. Now anyone looks at also, they can understand easily without even my explanation. That is the core purpose of this annotation. Now let us move to with two sample. See, this is between one sample, x and y. Now we are moving to two samples. What is a two sample? X is fixed. Maybe for example, I can say, this way I can say age I am fixing. 10 year, 11 year, 12 year, 13 years, or something, some age, around 10 age group people I am considering. The adult group, 13 to 20 age I want to consider. Then I can collect their package of salary or their weight, body mass weight I can consider. Another one is height. Age relativity with weight, age relativity with height I want to look at. Age and relationship between height and weight. That situation, this will be useful. If it is real-time case, right now also I'm not having real-time data. Simulated data only I'm working on. I'm just initializing X with the array of element or list of element. Already we know list. 1, 2, 3 I'm initializing. Y I'm initializing with 50, 60, 70. Imagine this may be mark, whatever. Just a number. 20, 30, 40 I'm initializing. Now, these are all gathering the data. Upon data, array of information only, plot can be done. That could be anything. If you have real-time data, Excel data, I can fix all of your age. Some of you may be 17-year-old, first-year guy, second-year guy, third-year guys, many varied group of people you are attending. If I know all of your age, I can collect here. If I know all of your weight, I can collect here in the Excel sheet. If I know all of your height, I can collect here. Then I want to plot it, the relationship between your age and height, age and weight. That is what I mean to say. Now, in order to differentiate, we want to give plot X and Y we have seen. Slowly, I'm complicating the same plot function with the third parameter, marker equal to X. You can give anything. Why you are giving X? Look at this. See, X. This is one point. X and Y relationship. This is one point, X and Y relationship, this marker. Next one is this marker. If you wish, this cap symbol I'm giving. If you don't like, give any symbol. Whatever symbol you like, among the keyboard symbols only you can give. Hash symbol, you can give hash. Say I'm going to give hash. After execution, this cap symbol will not be there. Triangle-like symbol you won't find. Hash symbol only you will find. Look, let us look at. That's all. Third one is marker. This keyword you should use is equal to X. If you don't want marker, what it will happen is, see, look at this only will happen. Wait a minute. I will change this and you will be able to understand. Comma, marker equal to cap symbol I am giving. Whatever symbol I like, I can give. That's all. I'm liking this cap symbol. Let me execute. Look at, you will have much more clarity. Which point versus which point this curve started, which point which which other point curve is continuing, at what point the curve is stopping. That is the meaning of marker. Earlier without marker I did, now with marker I am doing. That's it. Now you would have, hope you would have understood these two lines. Now I need to set the limit, x limit, y limit. This lower limit, upper limit, lower limit, upper limit, I need to set. Here you may ask question, why you didn't set? Without setting, automatically it adjust. If we set, it will be within our control. If you don't set also, it will do, it will plot. But what range it takes, you and me cannot predict. When we set, the plot will be with, yeah.
Few students are waiting. Please add them.
Waiting. Yesterday also people were telling, sir, it auto admit I gave. There is nowhere I can see waiting. I am looking at, see, nowhere I could see waiting.
Okay,
ma'am. I already enabled auto waiting, auto admit. Not even single one I am admitting.
Okay.
Okay, sir. So now let us move to limit, x limit. I want to start with 0. You may ask why 0? Yeah, let me change 0.5. See, now you can change, see that, look at, capture in your brain. If the plot x limit starts with 0, here lot of vacuum I am seeing. Why to waste this? Let me push to 0.5. Let me fix to 3.5. Yes, it is possible. Instead of this 0, I need to put it as 1. Instead of this 0 also, I need to put it as 1. That's all. Then length of x plus 1. What is the length of x? This one. List, yesterday we have seen. That is why this all foundation we have discussed already. Length of x plus 1 I am putting. 3 plus 1, 4. So this ends with 4. I don't want length of x plus 0.5 is sufficient for me. 0.5. Yes, fine. It won't tell anything. Now y limit. Similar, y I don't want to disturb. Let it be y as such. Only then you can notice a difference. Now after that there is no more question. I am slowly increasing the complexity of the same plot. Nothing I am doing. X label, I am giving one title. Y label, I am giving one title. Then total plot, I am giving one title. Let me change this also, capitalized L. Let me change this also. You can notice. Similarly, legend. Legend means each and every line, later on you will get confused to interpret. For example, if I am comparing your age versus height, age versus weight, then blue would become height, pink would become, orange would become height. That significance we will come to know. For that we are giving, since it is simulated data, no significance I can see, so that I am giving legend of sample 1, sample 2, because two lines, so that I should give two titles. Then location, where it should be displayed, upper left corner. That is why it is displaying on the upper left corner. After telling all our requirement, we need to tell plot.show. If the moment you say plot.show, whatever we were dictating so far now, it will consider all our prerequisite. According to your specification, it will plot. That is the meaning plot.show. Let me execute now. There is an error. Wait a minute. Capturing the error itself, very big difficult. Yeah, hash is not permitted. That is the problem. Instead of hash, let me give the original, what is mentioned, cap symbol. Hash is not permitted because it is having the specific meaning. We can give, instead of that, I can give star also. Star will not give error. See, first one is x, second one is star. Plotting, starting with the x limit 1, y limit 3.5. It stopped. Now it is pushed. The earlier and this one, you can notice, then all are capitalized. That's it. Nothing more. You are fixing the limit. You are bringing the plot under your control so that you are giving x limit, y limit. If you don't want to give control, you leave it. It will do automatically. We no need to worry of that. The earlier one I give cap symbol so that we will go back to original. What is this original? I tried with what was there earlier? One. Yeah. One was there. And here it was there 0. Here it was there 0. Enter. The original plot I have brought back. That's it. this looks little bit better than what I plotted. That is why I don't want to change. But for your learning purpose, I have demonstrated. So there are a lot of plots, useful plots. These are all a familiarity I'm making you to be versatile with the plotting technique. Box plot, lot of plots. When data is there, then it will be more interesting. We can relate, we can understand the relationship between the plot. The core purpose of plot itself is to understand the relationship. Always we say, image speaks 1,000 words. So that anyone can able to understand rather than numerical plot. Even most of the industry shows on their dashboard, even Amazon dashboard, if you look at, it shows with the plots, trending, everywhere reporting during the brainstorming session, meeting presentation, people will go with beautiful plots. So in order to do that, plots are important. Similarly, why plot? Whenever you are writing project report and research paper, this all is mandatorily expected. We need to include plots, we need to include figures, flow diagram, table. Only then your paper will be accepted successfully. So that we are doing this all plot. If you ask question, is it mandatory to learn plot? Choice is yours. Without plots, with descriptive statistical analysis, with a numerical value itself, you can keep articulating writing if you are versatile in it. But with figure, even the person who is not related to that domain itself can able to perceive things easily. That is the advantage. Nothing more with the plot. Now with three sample, simple for, it's kind of play, game I am doing. See, X, cap symbol, star. Then three, X, I am making it as fixer. Why different? For example, age versus mark, or I can fix, this is section one mark, section two, yeah, year one people, year two people, year three people, age and marks, is there any difference? That kind of analysis. It is depending upon your situation. You may, mechanical guys, you may think of friction versus corrosion. Due to element friction, you will be turbines, motors, you will be kept on rotating. Because of that, is there any damage in the metal? Or is there any corrosion in that metal? Something kind of analysis you can do. No, by that time, what is the amount of friction you are applying? Then what is the relativity of corrosion happening in the metal? That kind of analysis and all, you need to relate and you need to show like this figure. So for that, it is useful. Now, three samples I'm collecting. Every sample I'm mentioning to plot. I'm asking Python to plot. Then I'm giving mark, X mark, cap mark, star mark. If you don't want mark, leave it. Then you will not able to understand which point it is taking turning point, where exactly the point lies. That information we may miss out. Nothing more is a problem. Then you are bringing under your control X limit, Y limit, X axis, Y axis. These are all simple annotation. Nowhere it is useful. X label, Y label, legend. Then color. We no need to mention the color, but it is possible to mention the color also within the plot function. But I am not right now sure about that syntax. Yeah, this plot function itself has several parameters. Among all the parameters, I am using only three parameters, started with only two parameters. If you want to change the color, it will give you freedom to change the color. Choice is yours. But right now I am using default color. Although it is default color, every plot is made with a different color. That is enough for me. This plot is having this color, orange color, blue color, green color. That is enough for me, sufficient. So I'm feeling comfortable. Now, plot.show, always I will be signifying at the end, whatever the necessary data initialization, package, inclusion, and what plot we want to do, what style we want to do, and limitation of x-axis, y-axis, annotation of the plot. Everything you need to complete first. Finally, you need to use the function plot.show. This plot.show fellow will go and refer the remaining thing, then it will plot. That's it. Now we move to line plot with error bars. There is no big difference between plot function and error bar. Only the thing is, it will give this pattern, this bar pattern. See, look at this line pattern, error bar pattern. This is kind of pattern. Nothing more is a problem. This is another. If you wish to display the figure like this in your paper publication, you do it. If you don't like this, then go for plot.plt.plot, this function, what we became familiar so far. Now this function itself, we can stop it. This is different style. Now we are giving x value, y value, error rate value, all the three together we are trying to plot. See, error bar accepting x value, y value, error value, and the pattern. And here minus x, here this kind of pattern we need to give. What pattern? This is also format here, not that pattern. There we were using the word called marker. Here we are using the word called format, FMT. That is the only difference. Then x ticks, plot x ticks comma x underscore labels. So this ticks where we need to do. It needs to be done related to x label, then x limit, y limit, annotations. After annotation, you are going for plot show. So that it relates not only x and y, it relates to error also, based on three parameters. One is x parameter, another one is y parameter, another one is y1 error parameter. Considering these three together, it is going to display with error bar plot. If you require in your context, you can use other. It is context dependent. Every plot is context dependent. We cannot say which is right, which is not right. Next, now what we are trying to do, log scale, whatever y value is available, y1, y2, that is transformed to log scale. See, log scale is 10 to the power of minus 1, 0, 1, 2. The entire given value is translated in terms of log. How we are doing plot dot y scale of log. So the moment we mention this function, naturally this y values are transformed. These y values are transformed to logarithmic value. Then it starts plotting. That is the meaning of this plot. There are plenty of plots, probability density function. See, now we are going to see one important function. This is required in the data science perspective, NumPy arrange, start, stop, step value. Linspace also the same structure. Linspace very first I introduced, in which start, stop, step value. This is the combination you will be using in the linspace also. NumPy arrange also you are using the same. D type equal to none. If you give automate, if you give what is a number you are trying to generate, that number it will be considering. Now let us look at same pack. One more question you may ask, every cell, is it necessary to include this? You may ask me, not at all. If you clip NumPy, that is sufficient. I am doing just a copy paste of that, little bit modification I'll be doing, then that is why I'm doing. I wanted to give full picture, so that I'm doing. In a single notebook, any one of the cell in the earlier, if you start executing that necessary packages, more than enough. No need to include in each and every cell, each and every time that packages. 1 minute. Color, color name. Yeah. Madhavi is giving color, color name, color equal to green. Yeah. Now let us move to this. Now this is called probability distribution, Gaussian probability. This is very vital topic, Gaussian probability, normal distribution. What is the meaning of normal distribution? This is called exactly normal distribution. This is not, orange is not normal distribution. This blue is bell curve, normal distribution curve, Gaussian distribution. This need to be understood by everyone before you step into data science. All the statistical packages, entire statistical model, working on the principle called normal distribution. Most of the, not all I can say, most of the statistical packages working on normal distribution. Difference between range function, arrange function. Range function is different, arrange function is different. Range will generate range of function only for the for loop. Here arrange function will generate, it will give the list of element out. range function you can have the combination only with for loop. This arrange function, it is useful for generating standalone data. Arrange function, that is a answer I can give. See, this will generate automatically the set of value what we have given, step value, initial value, final value. This is available in NumPy package. There are several computations sometimes duplicated in Python. That I don't know why. Why? Because it is open source community. Every package is brought by any one of the contributor. Every time the modification is also carried out by another team. Consistently, same team will not work. So they may be bringing duplication also. That is also chance. Now we come back to normal distribution. Look at, this is a normal distribution. What is the statistical package says? Most of the machine learning model, machine learning algorithms, most of the packages, even deep learning, wanted purposely the data need to be normally distributed. That is a minimum condition, that is called pre-processing the data. First, you need to verify whether the considered data is normally distributed. Every column you need to distribute. Your age column, your salary column, whatever the column comes now in your data set. For every column, if it is of numerical data type, you need to first verify the distribution of the data for every numerical column. If that data is normally distributed, you are bold enough to proceed with building the model. If not, you will ask question, what I supposed to do? You need to normalize the data, that the data is not taking that shape. There are several ways to find out normalization. Kurtosis is one of the technique available. Normalization value itself available. Skew function is available. Skewed data. If it is not normally distributed, it is skewed. What is the meaning of skewed is that shifting of the curve will happen. Either right side, shifting of the curve will happen. That peak will occur on the right side, or that peak will occur on the left side. Then tail will be more larger tail one end smaller tail. What is the tail? You see, this is the tail. This will be shifted like this. That is called, the peak will be there. So we have several methods to identify normalization statistically. If you are not comfortable to statistical methodologies to learn, then also you are welcome. You can do the plot if more or less it resembles this, either this graph or this graph, doesn't matter, any one of the graph, both are with respect to normalization, both are little bit better. But with respect to standard deviation, the deviation is more with this orange. That with this more, deviation is more. What is the meaning of deviation? I'll come later. First I complete normal distribution. It should become normally distributed. If you are not comfortable with a statistical package, you are well and good, but you should know plot. If you are not comfortable with the plots, you should know statistical method. Without knowing both, you cannot do any data analysis. You cannot work with the data. So that data says it should become normally distributed. Most of the model works on the principle called normal distribution. Now let me come to deviation. What is the meaning of deviation? If you look at the formula for deviation, it is, the basic requirement is based on mu. Mu is average or mean. Mean value, from the mean value, it starts taking the subtraction. Then it starts doing some square root or some kind of formula will come. Then when the subtraction is become more for few data or most of the data, it becomes more deviation. For this one example, I'll tell you. In your class, imagine there are 60 students. Among 60 students, most of 50% of the students are failed candidate. 50% of the students are having high mark, above 90. If I take average, what will happen? In this case, first I need to compute average. Then I need to find out the difference between average and every student score. Then whomever have got that near 90, there the deviation would become lesser. Whomever have got near zero, the deviation will become larger. Out of 33 candidates, 60, I said, no, then 30 candidate getting near zero value, fail also, not decent fail, near zero value. then if I start finding these combination of data, standard deviation would become very larger. Rather, another scenario I will tell you. In your class, all are getting good marks, all are brilliant student. Fine, everybody's mark is 80, 82, up to 92, some range. If I look at any student mark in your class, it lies between 80 to 92. That's it. There is no more combination. Maybe 1 or 2 beyond 92, 1 or 2 less than 90, less than 80. Then there is no deviation at all. Standard deviation is one of the primary descriptive analysis in order to understand the distribution of the data or nature of the data. This is how we need to interpret. Lot of deviations available in the case 1. In the case 2, there is no deviation except one or two students highly deviated. One student may be getting 10 mark, another student may be getting 98 mark. Rest of all you guys, 58 students are getting same band, 80 to 92 marks only you are getting, or 80 to 90. Let us put into still more closer, 80 to 90 marks only you people are getting. In this case, if I calculate standard deviation, you will not face any biggest issue. The deviation is lesser. When the deviation is more, that way we need to look at the interpretation is different. The deviation is lesser, that all the intricacies, it will be spoken more in the data science, not here. So, but I'm giving little bit of introduction between the standard deviation, normal distribution. This is also normally distributed. This is also normally distributed. However, deviation is more here, deviation is less here. That is the difference. Next, cumulative sum. These are all the way of plot. I will give you this notebook. You can keep working on it. Across two different category of data, what kind of plot you want, you are trying to give. See, step plot. If you give step plot, instead of connecting zigzag way of that line, it will give stepwise. If I plot without step, it will look very zigzag, the graph. But here it shows exactly where the changes comes, how much comes. That is the difference between the normal plot and the step plot. This is called scatter plot. See, given the scatter, all the points are given scatter plot. Then we are trying to connect the line only for cumulative value, cumulative sum value only we are connecting. These lines are representing cumulative sum value. The rest all are whatever the point, for example, your age and your weight, just a scatter plot. I can plot like this. If there is lot of deviation, the scatterness will become more. All are 18 years, 18 year, 18 year student. Your weight is 60 kg, 61, 60.5, 62. Then all the plot will look very condensed. That shows very much similarity. Whomever takes part in this session, you look, your appearance looks same. That is the meaning. Your age is also same. Your your weight is also more or less same. If it is highly scattered, there are very thin person in this group, there are very fatty person in this group. So that scatter is more, then wide or different category of people is. People are available in this group. That signifies, that's all. Now, another important plot is histogram, bar plot. These are all much more important plots when you come to data science. I wanted to introduce one more. See, look at carefully. The same function I started giving you here, import matplotlib dot pi plot as plot. You might be remembering what I am doing. Nothing I am doing. 1 minute. Here the syntax I am changing. 1 minute. It is saving. Auto save I have put. You need to put trusted, then auto save will happen. Look at this. There are two way you can import the package. I said that answer I am giving right now. One is you can use conventionally like import what plot or what package exactly you are expecting, what package you are expecting within that sub package also, and you are giving alias name. other method, you need to use from the major package name, the main package name, matplotlib, import sub-package as plot. There are two different ways you can do for same importing function. So don't get confused whenever you see from in the internet for importing the package. There are two different ways we are doing. See here, we are trying to include one more package that is called random. I'm not giving any alias name. If I'm not giving any alias name, I should use as such. If I give as alias name instead of this random, I can use R. If I am giving alias name as R, I can use R. Choice is yours. Since this random function is used only one time in my notebook here, I wanted to use just import random without any alias name. Directly I'm using. Now, import numpy, import random, import matplotlib. So if you like the same rhyming way, you can use or you switch over to from. Most of the time, you no need to write the code. Just copy paste from the internet. You should understand what that code is doing and what is your requirement, where or which parameter you want to change. That change in parameter is mainly important. You no need to sit and by heart Python code and all for advanced learning. Even data scientists, they will be asking what function you are using, what package you are using, higher level construct. They don't ask you very micro level construct. What is the third parameter? What is the fifth parameter? Like that and all, no one will ask question. It would become a bit matured and majestic way. So no one is expected to learn even micro level. You can keep communicating and keep doing it. Nowhere I can see admit. I think everyone can come and go and join automatically. Unless I remove. Yeah. Let us go back. Now, look at here. And generating a data, how the data is generated using NumPy, combining with random function, and I am demanding to give normally distributed data. Look at that. I'm demanding to give normally distributed data. Although I am plotting histogram, it looks normally distributed. Look at the peaks. Then I am mentioning 0, 20,000. So with that combination, it gives a random function. Although it gives random function, it gives on the principle called normally distributed. That is the beauty of this function. Bins, number of bins, how many bins we want. So np.arrange, arrange also will generate the number from the given set of range. So you can understand by plotting data separately or writing in a file, and you can write in the Excel sheet also. When I move on to dealing with data, you can able to understand. This also you can plot and you can understand. When you try to display this here, it will give very few points. Beginning and end and in between one or two only it will give. It won't give to the fullest. Because the entire notebook will go deeper so that it won't display everything. That is why it limits. Again, we are telling x limit, min and max. Now the function which we use is hist function. Same histogram we can display with the seaborn also. It is possible. But the way we plot histogram using seaborn is different from the way we plot histogram using matplotlib. The function is different. If we use seaborn, you need to search in the Google itself. How to display histogram using seaborn? Then people will give you the code. How to display histogram using matplotlib? Then the different. The appearance also will look different. Histogram plotted by matplotlib would become different. Bit the aesthetic approach. The matplotlib means the same histogram displayed by seaborn would become bit different. That is the only difference. Let us move back to this. Now, a histogram is going to take two different set of data. Data and bins. This bins you can give numerical also. I want 5 bin, 10 bin, 8 bin. How many number of bin? What is a bin is? This every grid is a bin. See, this is one small bin. Next is very tiny. Second bin, third bin, fourth bin, fifth bin. sixth bin, seventh bin, eighth bin. This is what bins. So number of bin, what, how many you are expecting, you can give. These are all simple annotation, nothing more. See, count variable x, bin size equal to 5, then random Gaussian data title, then plot show you are giving. Now you may ask question, what is alpha? Alpha is the transparency of the graph. See, I am going to give you 5. If I give 5, look at little more thick it became. Now I am going to give 0.7. It will become much more darker, dark blue. That's all. So this is alpha value is meant for the transparency. Within histogram also, there is a possibility to display the color, whichever your favorite color. There may be one more parameter. That parameter we should know the syntax, and where to give also we should know, before this or after alpha. Then it will give you your favorite color instead of the default blue color. That's it. Now this is called heat map. What is a heat map is, for example, after election, India Today kind of magazine would be displaying where the count had gone high. See here the color code they are giving. This color is for 0.8. Whenever you see this color, that is the highest value that signifies. Then they will display count. This particular booth or this particular section won the voting for BJP or for RSS or something. You can put all the Congress, all the parties. I am poor with politics. Just to put all the parties. See, this is the party won highest count voting. That is why larger region is covered with yellow. So they will display with the heat map. Then they will display the count here. Then they will give the interpretation. This is the region related to. They will load all the information, which section, which locality, or state wise also. This is the state, this is this state, something like that. Then here it will be seen the state. Here you can see the count. It is possible to display count itself on the box. So that is called heat map. Relativity, it will show the color code and relativity across several states or several sections or across several parties, whichever the party is getting what way. Then next is color map, the different colors, just for fun, how many colors available to play around with the color map. With that, then marker style, what are all the marking character. I was trying to do one marker, no, it is giving error. What is the marker I was trying to do? Hash symbol. Hash is not permitted. See, dot is permitted, comma, o, v, cap, less than, greater than, 1 2 3 4 8, S, P, star, H, capital H, small h, plus cross D. These are all the marker you can use. Hash value is not at all permitted. So that understanding, this has been brought. Possible markers. So with these all are the marker, how you can display the plot. That's all. So which marker will look, or how it will look, for that glance, this is available. Line style, next, dotted line. See, dot followed by bar, continuous dot. With this pattern, how you can display. With that, here we are trying to stop. If you wish, you can read this for more information. Now, this is very good, very rudimentary level they are teaching and explaining. But that code you can't copy. It is fixed. You can read and understand. You can't copy and you can't bring that code into your notebook. So now I will just introduce how we can get into data analysis. Before getting into data analysis, if you have any questions, you can have. Then I will switch over to the topic for another 5-10 minutes. Then we can stop. Difference between BTN range function. Yeah, you display and you try those all and understand. BTN, I am not sure. Range function is to generate range. With that, you can try. What is this? This Google sheet is not that loaded, the data. 1 minute. Meanwhile, let my thing get loads. Then I can move to data. tab. Now we are moving to data analytical aspect itself, reading the file and how to look at the data. Finally, I will show you the data after some time of explanation. NumPy, Pandas is another package. Without this, you cannot read the data. This is for all the mathematical manipulation, linear algebra. This is for data processing, like reading CSV file, input-output operation. All the file reading, Pandas is important. Then Matplotlib, just now we have seen. Another plotting function I'm using, package I'm using here, import seaborn as SNS. This is for advanced plot. Now set grid style, wide grid, sns.set_style. This is suitable only for SNS related displays. What is a grid style means? In the histogram you would have seen, where the first bin ends, where the second bin starts, no boundary. Everywhere it looks same color. If you look at that histogram, you may feel dizziness. Where how many histogram bins available, manually if I ask you to count, you may feel little bit strainful. In order to avoid that, you can display that histogram with white grid. Outside of every bin will be having the coating in white color, white grid. That is the purpose of this. We are trying to mention here itself. The style we are mentioning here itself. If you wish, you can remove this and you can mention what is the way you want to plot in the function. Where whenever you are trying to plot something, that moment you can bring this. Next, ignore warning during execution. Normally in Python, warning also, error also, it would give, it will speak a lot. You would have seen. I just used a hash, how much it was warning, error. So warning also, it will become very bulk in nature. Then warning normally we no need to consider, we can ignore. We can proceed with more. Many notebook, I have got warning, I don't bother, I just proceed. In order to ignore warning, I don't want warning from you. Just keep quiet. If you want to tell to notebook, then we are ignoring the warning. For that, we are trying to give import warnings, warnings dot simple filter action equal to ignore. You can just copy paste whenever you are working with the data analysis, this code. If you have code, you can, but you should understand what context we need to use, why we are using. That is the only requirement. Now this is a kind of variable. This is a kind of variable, but when it comes data science, technically you need to use, it is called data frame, name of the data frame. That is why DF is given. Not necessary to give DF all the time. You can give your name, your city name, your favorite food name, anything you can give. But whatever you give, that is called data frame. Now let us go back here. Data frame equal to, I am using Pandas. That Pandas, this P-A-N-D-A-S, Pandas. That alias name, I kept it as PD. So that I am using that PD dot read underscore CSV. CSV is the variant, it's a kind of file format of another file format of Excel. That's all I can say. Comma separated view. This is the meaning of CSV. You are trying to read, not write. If you want to write, you need to use different function. If you are trying to read from the existing data, it is available in my desktop. So read underscore CSV, single quotation or double quotation. This is not a problem. Any quotation. See, I will put double quotation here. Here I am giving double quotation. The second function I am using single quotation. There will not be any problem. Entire path you should know where you have kept your data file. That file path you need to bring. So file path when you are giving, you need to give double backslash. That you should be careful. Then file name should have the extension .cv. If you want to read Excel data file, underscore Excel you need to use here. Here you need to use .excel. Train.excel. That is the only difference for reading Excel file, CSV file. Don't be afraid. You taught a CSV, but my faculty is giving Excel sheet. What can I do? Nothing to worry. If you want to read Excel sheet, pd.excel you need to use. pd.excel, read underscore Excel. The file name, the faculty which you, who are all giving to you Excel, XLS. Here the extension would become XLS. That's all. So whatever that respective file name you can use, or you can Google it, it will give you. So this is the way. Now let me compile this or execute this first cell. Until star disappears, we need to wait patiently. We should not proceed quickly with the other cell. Star needs to get completed. If it completes only, I'm dependent on PD. PD is not brought to my notebook for my primary memory. Yeah, it has been done. One has come. This, what is the one means? How many times I have executed? This I have executed earlier. See, this cell I have executed twice. This I have executed thrice. This, something like that. How many times you are executing, it shows. Now I am going to execute this. Two. Successfully, my file is read. How can I know my file is read successfully? So you, there is a function called df1.head. Head function you can use. It will show it has 81 columns. Top 5 rows are displayed by default. If I give 10, it displays me top 10 records. If I am able to see what I have seen in the Excel sheet here also, the top 10 record, then successfully my program have read. If I want to look at like similarly for the data frame 2, yeah, DF2, look at the data, 80 columns. What is the difference between DF1, DF2? Look at, this has 81 columns. Because in data science, it is called test data, it is called trained data. In the trained data, one feature would become always excess. In the test data, one feature would become always lesser. That is why trained data, DF1 has 81 columns, DF2 has 80 columns. This is the function for looking at head of the data file. Tail function. Tail is also available. What is this tail function is? Bottom of your Excel sheet, it will display the 10 data. Head means top 10 cell. Tail means bottom, last 10 rows, it will display. 10 rows, all the columns also, it will display. That is the only difference. Now, I am introducing one more function called shape. I'll just see, this is simple print. We are already familiar with the print and I'm giving some annotation, comma. These are all explanation, English explanation. DF1 shape of zero. Zero always, shape is the function useful for knowing the number of columns and rows. Zero will give the number of rows and one will give number of columns. Simply if I put a shape, I will show you. Insert above. Now how I am going to do is df1.shape. See, nothing I am doing. Simply, this is like complicating. This cell is complicating. Simply if I do df1.shape, it tells me how many rows are available. 1460 data rows available. 81 columns I am having in df1. Insert below. df2.shape. Enter. In the second sheet, Excel sheet, 1459 rows I am having, 80 columns I am having. That only I am complicating here, nothing more. DF1 shape 0, DF1 shape 1, DF2 shape 0, DF2 shape 1. Then here it says some simple English, DF, that the testing set has one feature less than the training set, which is sales price. This column is not available with the test data. The target to predict, annotation, that's all. With that, let me conclude today. Already we reached almost 10 more minutes excess. I am having one at another meeting. If you have any questions, you can communicate in the chat box. Otherwise we can stop at. If there is no question, let us sign off from each other. See you all. Yeah. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
We need to give a vote of thanks, actually.
Okay, since fine.
Before five days, continuously you are putting your effort best to make them learn Python and data structure. And from 3D printing, synergy.